you. Let us pray. With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the remains of our sister Natasha and our brother Clay for burial. They were washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God, our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise them to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our sister Natasha and our brother Clay. We thank you for giving them to us, their family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Jesus said, I am the resurrection, and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he dies, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. To this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. Amen.
To him, great is thy faithfulness. Continue our service on page 4 of our booklets, the Collect for Purity. We say together, Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ. Alô. Amém.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, remember before you today your servants, Natasha and Clay, and we pray that, having opened to them the gates of larger life, you will receive them more and more into your joyful service, that with all who have served you in the past, they may share in the eternal victory of Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the Book of Wisdom, chapter 3, beginning at verse 1. But the souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and no torment will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seem to have died, and their departure was thought to be an affliction, and their going from us to be their destruction, but they are at peace. For though in the sight of men they were punished, their hope is full of immortality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great good, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Those who trust in him will understand truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his elect, and he watches over his holy ones. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh, A reading from the Word of God, written in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, beginning at verse 13. We would not have you ignorant, brethren, concerning those that are asleep. They may not grieve as others do, who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus Christ, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, shall not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a cry of command, with the archangel's call, with the sound of the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah.
prevail.
All fear is gone, because I know He holds the future, and life is worth living just because He lives.
Be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, according to John, chapter 6, beginning at the 37th verse.
Glory to Christ, our Savior.
At that time, Jesus said, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and anyone who comes to me, I will never drive away. For I have come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of Him who sent me. And this is the will of Him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that He has given me, but raise it up on the last day. This is indeed the will of my Father, that all who see the Son and believe in Him may have eternal life. And I will raise them up on the last day. This is the gospel of Christ.
Please be seated. First, I wish to offer our sympathy to all the loved ones of Clay and Natasha and Clay, particularly their parents, and that the unnatural progression has happened, in that parents are interring children. So we are recognizing the pain that would bring, and praying that through God's grace that you all will be able to bear it and continue the journey of life. Of course, missing those whom we love, but always mindful, as the letter from Thessalonians just reminded us, that we are to mourn as people with hope, not as those without hope, who quickly forget that we are a resurrection people. So I encourage you, we've been praying for you all, we will continue to pray for you all, and then by the grace of God, you will have his strength. The last I saw Natasha was quite, I know she had traveled, and the funny thing is, I would have, Deidre would keep me informed, but whenever Clay would pass, walking, you know, you normally take this track and come through the graveyard and go down Fox Hill area. And I would stop him and, how mommy, how Natasha. So you could imagine my shock when I heard he had passed, because I was seeing him and asking him for those who I knew were having challenges with their health. Well, that was something else when I got that news that he had passed. God knows best. So on behalf of myself, Archdeacon Knowles and Mrs. Sandra and our families, and Jillian, my wife, who attended Natasha at times when she was at Elizabeth Estate. So there's some connections. We also want to remember Father Andrew Toppin, who would have went to school with Natasha, and she would have mentored him and showed him around the campus of St. Augustine's, and I understand Raleigh, North Carolina, when he would have gone up there. He met her there, and she took him around the campus and enlightened him. So there are some cheerful things. One of the other wonderful things, and I was always on Natasha's case. She usually sit right in the middle there where Miriam is, someplace in them pews, and I would slow down because she could sing. She could have sing. I used to slow down. I say, we need you in the choir. You need to come up in the choir. And every Sunday when I pass, I slow down. But unfortunately, it was not to be. But I still remember that melodious voice. She really had a wonderful voice. And we thank God for her many gifts and talents and the ways that she would have impacted our lives. May we pray. Come, Holy Spirit, come and fill the hearts of your faithful people. Enkindle in us the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit and we shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May I speak to you now in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now, one of the things I like to remind people of is the fact that at a funeral, we ain't talking to the dead. The sermon is for those among us who are still here in this existence. So the sermon is not about the dead. Some people do eulogies, but I am going to speak directly to us. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me.
on anyone who comes to me. I will never drive away. Love and hate exists in our lives through the same principle, which is choice. We can choose to love, and we can choose not to hate, which is the same thing. We can choose to love and we can choose to hate. Love will not be genuine if one does not, of their own free will, choose to give it. Similarly, I believe hatred is a choice, as one can choose not to hold on to ill feelings towards another person. Please note that our text is not a violation of free will. The Greek word translated as everything speaks to the universal, the body of believers, which the Father has given to the Son. Then we witness the move from this universal, speaking to this universal notion, and then being more specific and speaking to the individual. So, we here, friends, and we witness this move to anyone, that everyone is the universal, that anyone is the individual. The group as a collective has been given to the Son. But the individual can decide to be or not to be part of the group. It is our choice. The Greek passage translated that anyone who comes to me suggests that one can choose to come or choose not to join the group. Therefore, one is not coerced to join the group by the everything that the Father gives me will come to me. That is not a coercion. Rather, friends, it is just stating that the Father has given the church to his Son, and the people are all part of the body of Christ, as Paul expresses it to us. Then comes the greatest guarantee of history, in my estimation. Any individual that comes and chooses Jesus will never, ever, ever be rejected. This is not like a life insurance policy. I know of any policy people in here. This is not like the life insurance policy that only accept you when you're young, strong, and healthy, when they think you will live long and maybe let the policy lapse so they don't have to pay. This guarantee, or guaranteed acceptance, is extended to the terminally ill as it is extended to the thief on the cross on the side of Jesus who was dying. Once we respond, we are expected to live a faithful life of love and service from when we are called until we are interred. And then we, one day, in the general resurrection, will be rewarded or suffer the consequences of our choices. We must constantly remind ourselves that love requires us to have a forgiving heart. In John 6 and 38, we see where Jesus goes on to express that he has come down from heaven to do the will of God who sent him. for us to have a deeper understanding of what Jesus' coming to earth means, we need to reflect on his earlier conversation in the same chapter of John, John 6. I want to use verse 27 to help, and we will, as we go along, we'll use other verses. John 6 and 27 says, "Do not work for the food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you." This advice follows a miracle feeding of Jesus. He had just finished feeding 5,000 people. And he's advising them to ensure they ain't caught up in this idea of this spectacular thing happening around them and mystified that he had fed 5,000 people with just two little loaves or two fish and five loaves. He's making sure that they ain't caught up in that and caught up in this notion of this temporary gratification. You know, that's what we like today. We like to feel good. We like those feelings and things that make us tingle. But being in a relationship with God is much more than the tingling that we feel. It is much deeper than the good feelings we will have. As then when things happen and we have to bury loved ones and we are hurting, then what? All of those good feelings are now buried so deep that we'll be digging and digging and digging to find them. What will we have to hold on to? So Jesus made them aware that something is going on here that is beneficial to your eternal good, as he will give them food that will endure to eternal life. As the conversation continues in chapter 6, Jesus references the wilderness experience. Remember, they were fed in the wilderness with manna. They even got water out of the rock. But he adds that his Father is the one who gives the true life-giving bread from heaven. And then they made a request of Jesus. In John 6 and 34, they said to him, "Sir, give us this bread, this one which will endure to eternal life. Give us this bread." And Jesus responds in 6 and 35, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty." Jesus is clearly connecting his presence to the true life-giving bread that comes from heaven and will endure for eternal life. The gratifying presence of this bread of life that Jesus continues to offer us who choose him and continues to offer believers today that peace, that fulfillment, and hope. On occasions, we attend comedy shows and consume some intoxicating products sometimes, or drinks that bring us some form of relief while we are at the show or feeling the effects of the product or drink. But they wear off. But what happens? The situation ain't gone. Still there. You still got to deal with it. And so we learn that with Jesus' presence in our life, in our lives, it brings with it that something that surpasses our understanding. St. Paul calls it that peace that surpasses the understanding of man. Choosing to believe in Jesus brings the kind of presence in our lives, brings that type of presence in our lives, this peace that surpasses our understanding. And so God has given us the ability to choose. Hence, we will enjoy either the rewards of our choices or the consequences of our choices. Choosing Jesus, the true living bread, will guarantee that we will receive food that endures and prepares us for eternal life. Preaching is designed to inform and inspire us to repent of our sins, ask for forgiveness, and forgive others as necessary. Then invite and accept Jesus into our lives as our Savior. Many of us who have been in churches all of our lives are sitting on the wall of half-heartedness, lukewarmness in our beliefs, uncommitted to this side or that, just standing there and claiming we believe something, but don't want to live it out. We have heard of Jesus. We know all of the formalities and the ceremonies. We are aware of them, but we are still in the valley of indecision. Today, we have an opportunity, as each time we come to the church, we have an opportunity to correct that. We will corporately acknowledge our sins. We will ask Jesus' forgiveness and be assured of his forgiveness. But I must challenge each of us. Each of us, because each of us have something in our minds where we may know that we need to correct a little something. I challenge each of us and any of us here today who needs to go somewhere and to forgive someone or to be forgiven by someone to find time and do it. Find time and do it. As soon as we can. If you have to make an appointment to see that person, make the appointment. It's best to make the appointment so that they could be prepared and know that you're coming to have a conversation. Here's the advice that Matthew gives us in Matthew 5, 22 and 24. So when you are offering your gift at the altar, if you remember that your brother or sister has something against you, what you supposed to do? Leave that gift there before the altar and go and do what? First, be reconciled to your brother or sister and then come and offer your gift. Adherence to this code will create more peaceful homes, communities, and certainly a better world. Indeed, I have a cousin who sang a song. He said that love is the key. Hear what Corinthians says in chapter 13. Love is patient. Love is kind. This ain't no romantic love they're talking about, by the way. If you know any Greek or a little bit of Greek, you're talking about agape. That is the unconditional love and the way that God loves us unconditionally. There's, you know, eros when you feel good and you see the one you love. That ain't this. This is agape. Agape loves no matter what condition you find yourself in. See, when your father and mother forsake you, the Lord will sustain you. That's the kind of love that's talking about. Love that is patient, kind, not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable. It keeps no record of wrongs. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things. It believes all things. It hopes all things. It endures all things. Love never ends. Never. That is not a romantic love, friends. That is the love of God that we are supposed to embrace as Christians, so that we can be people who live a life that is patient, kind, not rude and envious, but a way that embraces God's way. Coming to God is a personal choice. I can't make it for you. Hopefully, something I say may inspire someone to change where they are today. But coming to God is very, very personal, and a personal choice. Before I sit down, I just want to encourage each of us, choose love, choose God. Amen.
Let us all stand as we choose love, as we choose God. In affirmation of our faith, we stand and recite the Apostles' Creed. Let us with confidence and hope confess the faith into which we were baptized as we say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Now kneel for the intercessions.
Let us pray. For our sister Natasha and our brother Clay, let us pray to the Lord Christ, who said, I am resurrection and I am life. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Natasha and Clay, and dry tears of those who weep.
Hear us, Lord.
You wept at the grave. Bring our sister Natasha and our brother Clay to the joys of heaven.
Hear us, Lord.
Our sister Natasha and our brother Clay were washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give them fellowship with all your saints.
Hear us, Lord.
Natasha and Clay were nourished with your body and blood. Grant them a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom.
Hear us, Lord.
Lord, comfort us in our sorrow at the deaths of our sister and brother. Let our faith be our consolation, and eternal life our hope.
Amen. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our sister Natasha and our brother Clay, who were reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that their death may recall to us your victory over death, and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you've led the way, and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen. Our act of penance If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just and will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Pause now and reflect upon the way we have erred and strayed from the way that the Lord would have us be and do. Let us therefore confess our sins. Together we pray. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and one another in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are sorry and repent of all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. God grant us absolution, and the priest pronounces the absolution. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The hymn, Glorious Things.
Save your sins.
praise of man perform. Let the world deny or pity, I will glory in thy name.
Prayer of thanksgiving. Through your goodness, Lord, we have this bread and wine to offer, the fruit of the earth and the work of human hands. They will become our spiritual food.
All things come from you, O Lord, and all your food is you. Blessed be God forever. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who rose victorious from the dead and comforts us with the blessed hope of life eternal. For to your faithful people, O Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when our mortal body lies in death, there is prepared for us a dwelling place eternal in the heavens. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Lord and Father, to you be glory and praise forever. In your boundless wisdom, you brought creation into being. In your great love, you fashioned us in your image. In your tender compassion, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, to share our human nature. In the power of the Holy Spirit, you overcame the power of sin and death and brought your people into new birth as first fruits of your new creation. On the night that he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me."
And after supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to the command of your dearly beloved Son,
we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory.
And we offer you, Father, our sacrifice of thanks and praise. Send your Holy Spirit on these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, Jesus, our Lord and Redeemer. As we partake of this holy food of new and unending life, may your Holy Spirit establish us as a royal priesthood with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Blessed John the Baptist, Blessed Anne, and all your sons and daughters who share in your eternal inheritance through Jesus Christ our Lord. With him and in him and through him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, in sounds of everlasting praise. And now, as our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from a time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. God of promise, happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. God of promise, you have prepared for us a banquet.
Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant them rest. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant them rest. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant them rest eternal. The gifts of God for the people of God.
Our souls will be satisfied, and we will sing glad songs of praise.
Thank you. who would like communion, please come forward now for communion.
mercy on immense and free, for oh my God, it found out me. Lord, my praise the Spirit lay, fast bound in sin and nature's mind. Thine eye diffused a quickening ray. I hope the dark don't flame with long. My chain fell off, my heart was free. I hope then for and follow thee. My chain fell off, my heart was free. I rose then forth and followed thee. No condemnation now I dread, only in Him is mine. Alive in Him I live, just this divine. Oh, I approach the eternal throne and plead the crown to Christ my own. Oh, I approach the
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray that post-communion prayer together. Almighty God,
we thank you that in your great love,
you have fed us with the spiritual food and drink of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, and have given us a foretaste of your heavenly banquet. Grant that this sacrament may be to us a comfort in affliction and a pledge of our inheritance in that kingdom, where there is no death, neither sorrow, nor crying, but the fullness of joy with all your saints, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
commendation. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saint, your servants with your saints.
Rest the heaven no more, neither sorrow, but life everlasting.
You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind. We are mortal, form of the earth, and to the earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created us, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant, your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting.
Let us commend our sister Natasha and our brother Clay to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servants Natasha and Clay, O Sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set them free from every bond, that they may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, our Father, art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servants, Natasha and Clay. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, sheep of your own fold, lambs of your own flock, sinners of your own redeeming, receive them into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord.
And let thy perpetual shine upon them.
May they rest in peace. Their souls and the souls of all the faithful through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. laying down death by death, giving life the doors and the tomb. The Son of Righteousness is gloriously risen, giving light to those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death. The Lord will guide our feet into the way of peace, having taken away the sin of the world. Christ will open the kingdom of heaven to all who believe in his name, saying, "Come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you. Into paradise, Clay and Natasha, may the angels lead you. At your coming, may the martyrs receive you and bring you into the holy city, Jerusalem. Lord, now you may let your servants go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have of every people. Reveal you to the nations of your people, Israel. Pray unto them, O Lord, let light be sent to you.